When you stay driven like a car, y'all make it hard to fail. My nigga breaking down work like pause for sale. Bumping that new space, he say that shit hard as hell. Drug dealing music take me to the trap. When I kept a pack, rocking that toboggan hat. Spacey, when you do it, how you do it? That shit sound like that drug dealing music. Niggas getting money as they hustle to it. That shit sound like that drug dealing music. Pull up to the trap, they going stupid. This ain't space selling drug dealing music. They remember Savage in the cool real, making flips to that drug dealing music.
17 on the track, what up? Wave, the space is the wave, Tottenville TV, yeah, all the way live.
Yeah, yeah.
West Side, Mind Business as the West Side, the big threes.
Right. Okay. Y'all got it. Y'all got it one more time.
We big live.
Live and direct from Tottenville, pushing Tottenville TV. I'm Coach Cheese the Mogul. You all know it.
Big Cheese, OG Pretty Thug.
Look at it.
T-Real, Dick. I'm going to be T-Real.
T-Real.
We got
T-Real, man. Yeah. T-Real, man. Tottenville TV. We live. I'm going to take his mask off. We here with the space, man. West Side, Yanceyville, Stony Creek. Representing. Everybody learn a little something. Boss Lady, you put this in
there,
man.
Okay.
You already said shit.
Oh, okay.
Excuses for that, man. That ain't live, man. Dang.
I got some exclusive play for y'all now. I'm sorry, y'all. Man, I just, man, was so turned, man, happy to be here, man.
Yeah, man.
It's a beautiful occasion, man, around all three of my big bros, man, and just to be here to be able to represent the city, man, Yanktown, NYC, big threes, man, I love my city, man, and just to be able to be here right now and broadcast to the world about our hometown and where we from, Yanktown jungle, I call it. And how we survived out here and the animals that made us. And it's a lot going on in society right now. And the United States is really messed up right now. I mean, I just seen on live where they raided the White House or whatever. And I don't talk politics and religion, but well, only thing we can really do right now is worry about our society and our community. How can we keep our society
Space,
right?
Space, plug said, but before we get into that, though, let's go back to the three in Yanktown. This place you're talking about called Yanktown.
Yes, Lord.
And the three. So the people out there can get in tune with what location you're talking and speaking of. You know, tell us where the three come from and this Yanktown thing. What city is that?
Yanceyville, North Carolina. I'm big on numerology and astrology and zodiac and stuff like that, and threes have always been an important part of my life. Like, I ain't gonna give out my social security number, but in each three of the parts is a three.
Leave a credit.
Try
your cell phone.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to fuck with you.
While I was raised, that was why I really became myself was Stony Creek School Road 3904.
Right.
Third Avenue in Yanceyville, North Carolina is where everybody kind of learned where to hustle at. Our area code is 336, and there's three stoplights in the city.
Right.
So it's like everything down here is threes.
Yeah.
And when I throw threes, I'm not, you know, I'm not banging a set or anything. I'm throwing threes. It's like, you know, somebody called me Yanceyville Drake, Yanktown Drake one time.
Yeah. Okay, but Yanceyville. Y'all Google that, Yanceyville. A lot of good product coming out of Yanceyville.
It's Eric a factory.
Yanceyville, called Yanktown, too.
It's a factory. Yanfa May. What else you got?
Yanfa, also.
And so, you know, I just run with threes. And I look at myself as a three-sided person. I tell everybody I got three pieces of me that makes one person. It's Terry, Bud, and Space.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a triangle. These three pieces make who I am. So that's what I just feel about threes. That's why I say threes about Yanceyville, Yanktown, North Carolina. Oh, we call it New Yanfa. Man, we got so many names. Man, we're a small city with big dreams.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we are.
Right.
And we're a factory to so many things that people don't even like, even understand. It's like we got three clothing companies down here. We got Classic with Dre Swagger. What up, big bro? We got Brandon, we got B Cobb with Mercy Life. We got J2 with Yam for Maid. We got two comedians down here that's my classmates.
Hold up, before you go past the clothing line, let's look right here. This Brotherhood by Cochise the Mogul.
Right here, okay. The microphone. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, Brotherhood 101, you can find it online. Just go follow the page and stuff like that. Go ahead, Spade.
That's four right there.
Yeah. And Rock Bar Entertainment got a clothing line as well. If you want that clothing, look it up.
I mean, we got these.
Throw them over there.
My bad.
No, you throw me off at all. I was just thinking about more things down here that we got, we produce down here. We're a city that's known for tobacco agriculture. That's what our roots are. A lot of
Stephen Slade or something like that?
Just a lot of farmers.
Yeah.
A lot of farmers. We're a very rural city. We don't necessarily have a hood. Everybody knows everybody. And that's the beautiful part about our city. People actually come from other cities that's on the run to come lay low-key down here. It's a peaceful city. That's what we are.
So, boom, I'm going to get to this. Not to cut you off anything. Let's get to what made Spaceman and what started you and everything. You know what I mean? I know you're hitting the history of Yanceyville. We want to know about Spaceman.
Oh, yeah.
Trav gonna say it loud for y'all.
Yeah, really
loud. We don't have the mic. We just gotta talk loud.
But,
real loud.
Real loud.
Yeah. Over your story, Space Man. My grandma, Emma G. My grandma, Emma Lou. Yeah. When I was a little boy, my mother and my father, my biological father, they were in some, dark place with each other, and to kind of to help me as a little boy not focus on that and try to, you know, really help me be try to raise me the right way, she kind of put a notebook and a pen and a pad in front of me. She was like, write whatever you feel, whatever you think, whatever. And I would listen to songs on the TV. The first song that really made me like, I want to write music, I want to do music, was if you don't know me by now, you will never ever know me. Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes.
Right.
And I wrote that down, and I was like, man, this is what I want to do. And I've always loved stars. I mean, if you look up at stars in the night, man, it's like the skies put earrings on.
Yeah. Okay. You look up at a constellation.
It's like a full moon at night is like beautiful.
Right.
Wrong time, darling. I'll holler at you later, though. We're going to talk about the song. We're talking about a song on Sorry for the Space 2, King Band the Spaceman. It's called Too Long.
Yeah. But how did you get the name Space, though? Why are you the Space?
True story. I went to Myrtle Beach. With Shawshank the Ghost Producer, that's my big bro, man.
Shout out
D Shaw, man.
For me.
I know everybody wait for us to work together again. I feel like we like Snoop and Dre. We got our own sound, man.
I do too.
No disrespect to anybody that worked with Shawshank the Ghost Producer, but when we work together, it just click. It just makes sense.
Yeah.
And appreciate it. And so we were down in Myrtle Beach promoting Dan Vegas, or what a Lucky Nick Mailman, and a young fella. And we had a sample CD.
Yeah.
And so we was on the strip and everything. And the story is crazy. And it's crazy you got the rain right here, because I'll tell that part of the story in a minute. But we were down there getting the CD away. And I had to play a position before I really became an artist.
Yeah.
Behind the scenes.
What CD was y'all giving away?
It was just like a sample CD.
Of what?
Like Dan Vegas music and Young Fellas music.
Okay, Dan Vegas music and Young Fellas music.
Yeah.
Dan Vegas out of Danville and Young Fellas. Young Broken Home. Y'all already know what it is.
And Welcome Home, P. My boy P. Ryan. Matter of fact, you can check out our track Bossed Up on Reverb Nation / Spaceman 23. That's with two N's. But we were down there giving away these CDs, and I was just pushing so hard because I just always wanted to tell Shaw, like, yo, I want to do this. I'm the one. Give me a shot. And we ran into a Gucci Man's consultant, something like that.
Yeah.
And I was asking him a question. I was like, what do you think about rock music meets, like, music with a spaced out hip-hop sound? Right. And he was like, Lil Wayne. And I was like, damn. So the next time that Dan Vegas went around him to work with him, he was like, what's Spaceman at? So they called me, and mailman called me. He's like, yo, what up, Spaceman? I was like, Spaceman? He's like, yeah, man. He said, that's what the guy called you, whatever. And it only made sense. I love stargazing. I studied the Zodiac.
Right.
I love nighttime. My grandma and Malou used to always, and the older people when I was a little boy used to always say, well, he was drunker than the man on the moon or something like that.
Yeah.
It was always the man on the moon. And I mean, I walked so much and had to make walks or whatever, and the moon was the light that helped me get to the house. The stars painted the way for, you know, helping me get to the house, having the light to see.
Mm-hmm.
So it just only made sense. It just clicked. And space itself is a different, it's an acronym. It means swag plus a lot of crazy energy, or staying positive against controlling evils. So it's like, even with the word swag, I used to say it a lot when I first started my music career.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I would hear people talk about when they in the penitentiary, it means secretly we are gay. And that hurt my feelings a little bit. So, but
I never heard that.
Me either.
I never heard that.
Yeah, yeah. Shout out to Papa Pooh. You know,
yeah, this may be older
but
than
yeah,
us.
Yeah, yeah, it might be
older, older than us.
I ain't hear
it
either, though. But anyway,
go ahead, what you're saying.
I just came with a motto for we're actually working on a song right now. I hope it's gonna be on a Sorry for the Space 2 came back in the Space Man. It's a song to my daughter, but it's for all the young kids. It's called Stars Will Always Glow. If you're meant to be somebody, or you're meant to be successful, or you got a purpose, or you know, something big about you, you know, you're going to be seen. And it's like, no matter whatever you go through in life, just remember, you know, you focus on something. Even in the hard times, you got to get this taken care of. This is what you're trying to do. This is what you're trying to be. And you got to remember that you are star, you know, you got swag. So, you know, you're a star, you will always glow.
Let me ask you one question. Something stood out about what you said, and these two things jumped out at me. It was, what are you trying to do? What are you trying to be, right? And them big things that people need to ask themselves, what are you trying to do and what are you trying to be? Because we are pushing Titanville TV. So,
Shout out to Tottenville TV.
True indeed. James Titan behind
Wave. Wave in space is the wave.
So, what are you trying to do, and what are you trying to be?
I want to be a humanitarian and someone these young folks to look to take my life story.
Oh yeah,
and
good stuff.
Go learn from my mistakes and the things I've been through because like, a lot of people see me walk, and it's so crazy, guys, because today...
People see you walk.
I'm back on road today, and it's been so many people like, yo, I'm so happy for you. Man, you just don't know. You finally, you know, you walk, you try so hard, you finally, you know, breaking through. And what I used to always tell people was...
The man walked, man. Let me get you... We know each other personally, basically our whole life. And anybody who knows Space can tell you he walked to his job. He worked, he hustled, he grind. He go hard at what he's doing. He reach for it. He go to school and work at the same time and make music at the same time. And come and check all his people out at the same time every day on the scene, coming to see his people. Grind, hard. Pit bulldog over here. You know, the tenacity like that.
To the last scratch.
To the last.
You know, a lot of people say they got hitters and dudes that do that for them. My hitters, they old heads. They old enough to be your daddy, but old enough to also turn your little sister into one of their side pieces.
That's a nice sandwich, that man.
I'm dying.
And when I say to the last scratch, I know exactly what I mean. We don't quit over here. I was talking about being hurt recently or whatever, and I told my Papa Pooh, shout out to Papa Pete. I was like, people got it mistaken. There's a difference between a hurt animal and a hurt pit bull. Mm-hmm. A hurt animal run off, go recover. A hurt pit bull, he want to bite back and hurt you back because you hurt him.
Well, that is it.
Right, right, true indeed.
And that's what I felt like during that moment. It's like, I'm a hurt pit bull right now. But I didn't want to attack with being negative or whatever, because my biggest thing is the youth. And being respectful to my elders and making sure that the elders that are looking down on us look down on us with a negative light. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, these just young, all they do is smoke weed, run the streets and all this right here. It's like, one of my favorite bars is by Drake. It says, I get high to balance out the lows. Mm-hmm. So what, man? Shit's legal in California, Colorado, D.C., mm-hmm. The list goes on, Maine. It's going to be legal here soon. It's the energy of the universe.
I got to quote a fella verse. He said, a fella bar, he said, they say, fella, why you get so bent? I looked up and said the world fucked up, and I'm just trying to keep a balance. But sometimes I get distracted, like that Drake verse.
A-L-L-Y-F, young fella.
Right.
And a message to everybody out there. I seen something on Facebook this week, guys. I'm sorry. You know, I just want to cut away for a moment. There was a lot of people posting about losing, like, their mother or sister or uh-huh. brother this week. And, you know, we all on are connected on social media. And I posted a picture of a garden across the street from my residence. Mm-hmm. And I was trying to express to people that my older brother Lenny died in my arms right across the street over there. Like, used to be a house over there. He died in my arms on the back porch. Yeah. I watched the man go from looking mixed to gray as a shirt and in my arms. And I'm 16, and all I could say was, bro, you're going to be all right.
Yeah.
And I couldn't even cry the night it happened. Like, this is something you might just break down and cry about. And I was literally in shock while people just... While I was on the sheriff's department steps, and people hugging me saying, it's going to be all right, and they crying. And I'm just looking up at the sky like, did this just really happen?
Yeah.
And the world is so crazy.
Right.
Because that night before he passed, he was talking to his girlfriend at the time. And he said, baby, if something happened to me, don't worry about me. I'm okay. I'm good. Mm-hmm. And the night they were on the way to pick me up, he said, I just want to see my little brother. I just want to get to my little brother.
Yeah.
And my mother was, and shout out to my mama, D-Jack Space Mom. I was like, mama, can I go out with Lenny? You know, they want to pick me up. We're going to go hang out or whatever. I'll be back. She was like, I don't know, baby. I was like, mama, it's Lenny. It's your oldest son. And my mother was so worried. But he picked me up. He came in the house dressed up and everything. He's like, come on, man. We'll ride out, whatever. Man, we were just going to get a bag of weed. Mm-hmm. And somebody was making a robbery in the living room, and he didn't know a thing. Right. And he walked in the house. And people think, and people say, people crazy for saying different types of things. I literally grabbed the door tonight. I walked with him to every door that we went to. And something said, don't get out the car. I literally grabbed the door handle, and something said, don't get out. He was like, I'll be back, y'all. And all I hear him scream out, Ashley, and drop to the floor. And we take off, and I got to pull him out the house. He on the ground. And I'm like, man, he was just alive a minute ago.
Right.
And that's I see this every morning. Mm-hmm. But what I wanted to show people was, there's a garden over there. This is the garden of the Poole family, Gary Poole and Miss Trisha Poole. It produces vegetables for the city.
Right.
That they take to the farmer's market and sell organic.
Right. Right, we talking about the factory he was talking about, what Yanceyville is producing, factory.
And it's like, it looks like to me, it's like, okay, he was lost right there, but the vegetables that's reproducing over there, he's still giving off his energy or whatever. He producing beauty through the pain. I look over there and I see beauty and I'm like, man, bro passed away with him. Look at the vegetables over there, man. It's so beautiful.
Right.
And they over there working there every day.
Yeah.
And that's one thing people don't understand about the city. We small, but we some hard working people.
Right.
God, we work so hard. People really don't know how hard we work to try to have a life down here. Like, we're really hard workers. We're really built like that. Like, they see us hanging out because we see us hanging out because we trying to stay calm in this craziness. Because people look down on this city so bad.
Yeah, we got it right there. Everywhere I go, they trying to put cheese on the bread.
And what?
Everywhere I go, they trying to put cheese on the bread. Yeah, it's the American way.
So, that what kept you motivated throughout, you mean, your whole life, throughout your career?
Definitely.
And how did it affect you, though, you know what I mean, from the beginning of it, from what you just told?
Watching one of your close friends.
Yeah.
Passing your arm. Yeah, I knew him, too.
Yeah, he pretty good, cool dude.
He was on the road in his last days.
It was like... I talk about the connection so much because he really was a big brother to me and my little brother Khalil, my little brother Tiger. And he bought us Christmas presents and we had a moment one time, I'm gonna tell a story real fast. I don't know what happened, but we had a physical confrontation and he picked me up in the air. And he slammed me so hard to the ground, it felt like I swallowed a boulder. Like when I hit the ground, I literally said,
"He got me weighing 19."
Yes, Lord. Yeah. And I grabbed a knife. He was like, "We're gonna do it."
You grabbed a knife.
Yeah,
I'm killing loose.
Grabbed a knife. grabbed that butcher knife and we're headed that way. He was like, "Go and do it then." And he was like, "I love you, boy," and you know, you hug me or whatever. And but I feel like one thing about this, just throwing this out there, I feel like something about the people that's close to us, the people that we love, that we have in our lives. One thing they have to be able to do to be in our lives is to be able to chastise us. Mm-hmm. They have to be able to check us when we out of character or we doing something wrong or we out of pocket. They need to be able to say, "You know, you're wrong for that."
Yeah.
And be able to say it with their chest. Like, I don't care if you get mad if I say that.
Yeah. Because that's when they really your brother.
Right.
Or your sister.
Or your woman.
Or your woman. That's right.
Your woman's supposed to be able to chastise you.
Mm-hmm. Well, supposed to be able to correct you and protect you.
And he's supposed to be able to do the same to her. It's a partnership.
Preach this, baby. Mm-hmm. Please.
So, losing him, and I had to go see a therapist during that moment because I would be riding with my mother. You know, we talking and she trying to keep my mind off or whatever. And I would just black out back to the moment.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, she was taking the Blockbuster and Black when that was live. You know, we got Netflix now.
Right, right.
So, she was trying to keep my mind off of, but I was zoned back off into the moments. Right. But one thing that I always wanted to do. See, the thing that I call him my older brother, the reason I say that is because when people say things to you like this, he was like, "Look, boy, you're going to be a beast in football this year. Boy, I'm going to get you some creatine. We're going to work out. Look, you're going to be a beast this year. I know you are." And somebody believing you like that, he the person that I started smoking weed. I didn't know how to inhale.
Mm-hmm.
Right hand on everything. I really used to.
Yeah, yeah.
And Papa B said, "What am I in that?" Yeah, like. Yeah. And
Excuse me, we live, man. Sorry.
Yeah, mic check. Everybody
knows
what
the mic
check is. Y'all know what the fuck a mic check is. Look. If you have a problem with people hearing what you're saying, you might need to get you a microphone to protect your voice. Okay? All right, here we go. I think it's ready.
Yes, man. Oh, you gonna hit it like this, man? Protect your neck.
Yeah, put the cuff on it. Yeah, put the cuff on it.
Yeah, you don't
get cuffed. He act like him perform on stages and walk on balls and shit.
Hey,
he playing.
But, you know, he was the first person I really smoked weed with. He really went to my papa pool and was like, yo, Bud smoke, man. And he was like, man, Bud don't smoke.
I was
going
to say, I thought you were talking about me. I ain't did that with you. Shit.
And,
incriminate me?
And he was just my big brother ever since of the word. And so my thing was, I lost him, but...
That's CBD. Shout out to all the CBD people, and with hopes that y'all sponsor some good people who promote y'all product.
I'm a weed CBD smoker, and that's what the name's about. Weed, this is the dragon right this. Here. Y'all gonna see me fight the dragon up in a minute. Higher than you want to be. You know that's my thing. Anyway, he was just my brother ever since of the world. I just wanted to make him proud. I feel like the people that we lose that are close to us, they die, but they don't die. I feel like their spirit still lives around us in some kind of sense. Like, angels live forever. That's my motto. And I just wanted to make him proud. Like, he really believed in me as a person. Like, that's one thing society, I think, lacks that really needs more people believing in people. Like, one of the most beautiful investments you can make in life is believing in people. Yeah, investing in people. Like, really, like, when nobody else was there for them, and you say, hey, you're going to be all right. You're going to make it. You're going to be all right. Trust me, it could be worse. It's people out there going through worse than you. And they really take your advice, run with it, change, and come back to you and say, man, I remember when I was like this, but, bro, man, I'm living in this house with this woman, working at this job, bro. I don't mess around over here no more, bro. I'm good.
And I appreciate you.
Yeah. And Brother Chief, that's why all the same way with me and you. That's right. Where our bond is at. Mm-hmm. That's how we do. Same way with you, OG Pretty Thug. That's how we rock.
Uh-huh. Yeah. We feed each other.
And people look at us like a small city, but I just named out you four companies. I just named out two comedians. I mean, we got so many people from this little city that's doing so many big things in front of the city.
You said they went to school with you.
Terrence T.K. Moyer. That's my homie. That's my bro. I love you to
Terrence
death, boy.
Terrence Keith Moyer. Shout
I
out.
Love you to death.
Yeah, for me.
And my white boy, John Carden. I see you too as well, boy. Man, but I got so many.
Oh, I got one. Country. He performed out there with y'all in the Civic Center.
Okay. And shout out to my partner Lil Bill too, man. He just came and seen me this week, man. And so, man, like putting on for my city, man, I went through so much. I'm a Scorpio. And one of our weaknesses is like really loving things and getting attached to them real deep. And it's been like that for my city. It's like, I've screamed Yanceyville in places and people have been like, hey, where is that at? Oh, why? You don't need to say that on the track, man. Don't nobody know where that at and stuff like that. I really took these bullets and smiled and like, anyway, man.
What do they think representing is? Like, you gonna fail to do that?
How you see Yanceyville now, though? And the people in them, like, seriously?
I see a factory. We just had... A lot of people don't know, we just had one of our best football seasons in, like, the last 15 years. Mm-hmm. We lost one game, and we lost in the playoffs. But other than that, we lost one game. We could have had an undefeated season. This is real, way before the COVID-19 pandemic hit.
Yeah.
And it's like, the times are changing down here. But they see us as being so small. That's the beauty about us. That's where the peace comes from. That's why our crime rate is low. Mm-hmm. That's why everybody gets along. That's why we able to do these things, collaborate. Because we are so small. Right. It's these other cities, our surrounding cities. Mm-hmm. They got so many people doing the same thing and building so much hate and envy for each other. We don't got time to hate and envy each other. We trying to get up out of here and do something bigger.
Protect and project
each
other.
Juice God, what up? Yeah, for me, man. I definitely got a shout out to my clothing company I'm investing into, man.
Just tell me this, then. How can you help, like, I'm going to say, young cats that standing around, you see ain't going nowhere. How can you feel like you can help them?
What can you tell them then?
First thing you got to do is you got to pull them to the side. You can't have a conversation with them while they're around everybody in the streets or around their homies or whatever. You got to really get solo dolo.
Yeah.
You got to get one-on-one.
Mm-hmm.
So y'all can cycle the energy in your conversation, in your convo.
Right. It can be straight.
And you can't be distracted.
Straight to each other.
Because, like, you could be one that trying to give him free game and get him to the next level. And somebody on the side of him would be like, man, that nigga don't know what he's talking about, man. Man, fuck that nigga, man.
Yeah.
Nigga, hit the blunt, man. Take a shot. Mm-hmm. Let's get one-on-one. And I just had a combo with my little homie Jeremiah. I called Lil Cuz before I came here tonight to do the interview. We had a long conversation about, you know, getting the money. You can get the money in the type of ways, but clean it up. We in this house right now. We all in the house.
Mm-hmm.
But we couldn't be in that house if it didn't have a concrete or a brick foundation.
Mm-hmm.
We need solidarity. It's cool if you want to do music. Everybody want to be the rapper, rock a lot of chains, sleep with a lot of women, make a lot of money, brag about it, smoke a lot of weed, take a lot of drugs, party, little rock star lifestyle. That's cool.
Right.
But you really got a 2 out of 10 chance of being that guy.
Mm-hmm. And when you say that, you speaking of in the entertainment field and projecting talents and things like that.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah, I understand that. And how they overrate that position. They overrate that. Well, when I say they, I mean people in general overrate that gap. In that position that you can get in to be the top star in the world. When they sitting here looking at it and they see it ain't nothing but 3 or 4 top stars in the world, just like it ain't but 3 or 4 superstars that go into the NBA every year. But you got million people trying to get it.
Big old fact.
It's like trying to hit the pick 22, motherfucker.
You still got other basketball players still go to. Like you say, it'd be big stars, but players still go.
And I definitely
they still get paid.
I don't mean to cut you off, but T-Real, but I gotta say this. I know you're gonna agree with this.
Try,
I want to give a shout out to my man Witness, the Soul Winner, man. I have to respect one thing.
What's his name?
Witness, the Soul Winner. That's the original name right there. But I like Nyshawn, the trendsetter.
Okay. I like Scientific.
Nyshawn, the trendsetter. Scientific.
I like Scientific. That's my name for him. That's what I got in my phone. Scientific.
I think it's just, you know, make sure you check out that interview as well, too, because that's my guy, man.
On Topville TV.
On Topville TV, man. I was rhyming. Freestyling or whatever, but he really taught me how to script my bars and make songs. I opened up his notebook one day and it was red. It was all in cursive and red ink. And I was like, now I just want y'all to hear it. Now I opened up the composition book and every song, every bar I wrote is in red cursive ink. And the numbers is lined up down the page. I was like, so, okay, this is how you do it. So where he got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I'd be like 1, but it's 2 bars. So this also helped me with as freestyling as well. Like, okay, this is the jab, jab, then the hook, bam.
Yeah, okay, them lines. And, what you saying? You saying the bars is jabs? Boom, boom.
Yep.
Boom, 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 boom. And then the hook is pow.
Okay.
And
it's like
you just gave away $10 million.
It's like when you freestyling, like when you watch battle rappers, like Sue Surf, Murder Mook, my favorite battle rapper, Goods. I'm just thinking about the battle rapper.
I'm sorry, y'all. You killing me, good.
Hey, look, shout out to
I'm
Bop.
I'm sorry, man.
Trademark. Sponsorship is well appreciated.
Wade.
Trying to be a TV.
Wade's Bop. Insane, man.
White life. Vodka.
Hey, yo. We're going to be back with a word from our sponsors, man.
Let me tell you this.
I got a commercial break, man.
No, you ain't got a commercial break. Ain't no commercial breaks. No.
Yo, I gotta. I use the bathroom.
Oh, okay. Well, this live. Go use the bathroom. Cheese, he gonna talk to you. He gonna talk to you on this live. You gotta use the bathroom.
Okay.
Excuse me. He's gonna cheese.
Talk a little bit about what we're gonna do. I guess we're gonna go into Titan Beer a little bit. Talk about Titan Beer, TV, and
we're going to DC right now.
What we're gonna do? We're going on to DC and take Titan Beer TV to DC.
We're gonna take it to DC and we'll do the same thing them niggas did the other day.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, we're gonna see how many of us gonna make it back.
I ain't gonna use them telephone here, cuz.
Oh, I'm sorry. Damn. You hope ain't nobody. We playing. We ain't going nowhere.
Okay.
We're going to Bojangles.
We do got on that.
Supremes.
We do got on
that. Fries and seasons on it. That's what we're gonna do.
Right.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't come give you like, dang.
Yeah, but look, anyway, it's time to mend y'all communities, I guess. I think it'd probably be time to mend y'all communities. Like, that's just what I see. My vision, I'm looking at it like this. Okay, if some unidentified mob has attacked a federal building and repeatedly said that it is a revolution, that means it's a group of people together that knew what they're doing at the same time.
Organized, man.
Organized. All right, so now I'm like, okay, well, how can a group of unorganized people get organized real quick? The best thing to do probably would be to organize within your village or your community, wherever you live at, wherever the end of the street is at, team with them people right there. Wherever the end of the street is at, team with them people, find the leaders in that. Man, I don't even know if I can keep on talking right now.
Yeah, you might tell them too much, don't you?
I don't even know if I can keep on talking right now. You know, yeah. I don't know if I can keep on talking right now. Yeah. Cause you know what I'm saying. Cause this shit might get started too fast, boy. Cause we really dangerous.
You bet.
But it's a killer loose, and it always been a killer loose.
He gonna tickle, baby.
I don't know about y'all. It was a killer loose, but it's always been a killer loose.
Always been.
Understand that.
He tickle.
Understand that.
I gotta take the microphone, man.
Hey, yo, I gotta get one.
That little girl said she got maced because she was trying to run up in the Capitol building, and then the people said, folks said, she don't need to come in there. And they said, well, why are you trying to go in there? She said, it's a revolution. It's a revolution. What's it? If it's a revolution, if I look up the definition of revolution, I would say, you can't revolution against nobody. So,
I don't know what happened.
Who is she revolutionizing against? Are you with her?
Or you got live.
You with her on the other side. So then, if you ain't with her, then you on the other side of the revolution. You are under attack. If you ain't with her, you on the attack. And do what you want to do. That would be just a good idea. I just think that it all would be in mind. That's just a good idea. I ain't saying that's the way to do it. That's my idea in the group. We need to get back into the sport.
I'm in the video.
I don't know what to do for real. real. I done heard so many lies, I don't know what the truth on my own space
time. Sometimes I feel like what's the truth. Arguing about who good for who. Let's get it straight. I close my case. I know my space and you do too. I met a star so good.
She got me space, got so high that I'm in my Hoover coupe. Just trying to make a move or two.
I just wanna
ride with Shawty. She
feel
mutual. And wherever we land,
you got
the business, no cue. Cool, yeah. Make you move. Call the world out, man. We're gonna freestyle in a minute, though, man.
Everybody,
I'm playing that Spaceman and Young Fella right there, man. Definitely make sure you go check that out, man. Go to Spotify. Young Spaceman, so I'm saying, I am so sweet. I'm streaming that right now.
What is your Spaceman name?
Make sure you get that Pisces tape, man. Big Waves, man. OG Smith, D-Nice, the whole Rock Bar team, C-Demo, Dude God, J2, Metro, man. A-Town, the whole family, man. John John, what up? My cousin, Big Baby. But I also want, man, make sure everybody, these young folk understand, man, these young men not understand. You know, put all your babies in the basket on you. Like, you really.
Hit on it.
It's gonna go off anyway, it's good. You got this, man.
It says space out.
All right, now what you said to the young people about not putting all their eggs in the basket?
You know, I preach, I go to college and go to school because I try to show the young folk how to stay in the road. Like, you always want to be focused on having to take care of objectives and getting stuff complete and getting things taken care of. It builds character, it builds confidence, it builds so many things. And like I was saying about the house, like, you can't be in the house without the concrete foundation or the brick foundation. You got to have something solid that's going to bring in a stream of income for the rest of your life. Or it's going to bring in that money. It's going to bring in the paper. It's going to take care of your bills. It's solid. Music is not a guarantee by any means. There are so many people wanting to be the next big rapper. And there's so many people that's not going to be the next big rapper.
Dude.
So, I go to school, and I try to preach the same thing to the young folk. Like, you know, you ain't got, school might not be for you, but get something that's going to keep you in the road, to keep you focused on what you got to take care of, what you got to do. Oh, you got something to take care of, you got something to do. They're going to pay you for going to school. They're going to pay you for being a student. Matter of fact, school is a job to me. That's what it is. I do my schoolwork. Make sure all my paperwork is taken care of, and that's my job, and they pay me for doing that. And I'm taking this information to go to the next level so I can open that group home for young boys and have that wing for young girls and make sure that it, because my life mantra is the seed, the youth are the seeds to the betterment of a better society. If you want society to be better, you got to teach the next generation to be better. The generations that's passed, their job is to tell the ones that's coming about their mistakes. Mm-hmm. That's their job. The ones that's coming, though, you got to make sure that they ready for what they about to face. And my dream is to be a counselor at a high school for seniors about to graduate. And
like guidance counselor.
Yeah, going into the real world. Because you don't necessarily know what you want to do when you graduate, when you walk the stage. Mm-hmm. They say go to college you gonna be the next ball player, or all these things. You don't necessarily know that for sure. You still trying to figure yourself out. And then you need somebody to say, hey, look, not pressure that young student to say, hey, you need to do this right here and do this right here and you need to do this right now. But say, hey, man, it's okay if you ain't figured it out yet. But the most important thing is make sure you stay disciplined and stay in the road of school till you figure out what it is that you want to do.
Well, those I do a trade. I'm a barber, stylist, and I ask some kids a lot of times. I ask them, well, what are you planning on doing when you get out of school? And they in like the 11th grade. They in the 11th grade, and I say, what you planning on doing when you get out of school? And they say they don't know. They say, I don't know. And I'm like, you don't know. You know you're in the 11th grade, right? You know there's only one more grade behind this. So what are you planning to do? What do you do now? A lot of the boys say they play Fortnite. They play 2K22. That's all they do. So then they don't know what they're going to do yet. They 17 years old. They only got one more year left in the house. And I say, maybe y'all should come up here and learn how to cut hair. Maybe y'all should learn how to style people. Facts. Maybe you should get a trade, because I believe you can make money off a trade without a degree. So if you can make money off something without a degree, if you desire to do something with a degree, then I think you can use that money to pay your tuition instead of getting loans that you got to pay off.
But a trade is more important than a degree.
Yeah, you're going to know how to do something to make money with.
HVAC, electrician, truck driving.
Once you learn it, you got it.
Yeah.
Truck driving, HVAC, electrician, plumbing, carpentry, roofing, siding, all the things that design life as we know it. Don't need a degree. All of the gray areas, the things that's been mixed in the wash, that's the stuff you need a degree for. All the people that we look at as cheating society, this what you need a degree to do, like be a doctor, be a doctor, be different. Everything to take 3 or 4 steps to get to. You know what I'm saying? Everything to take 3 or 4 steps to get to. When the things that's just right in front of you, like plumbing, is a pipe that go out of your toilet and go out into the sewage. Something simple like that. Knowing how to do that is valuable.
Facts.
And you can teach a kid how to do that. You can teach a kid how to use a shovel and put pieces of puzzle together. And that's what plumbing is, putting pieces of puzzle together. But anyway.
I'm glad you brought that up, though. Just going into your what you were saying about the trade.
We hit you, man.
It's like that's the biggest thing. It's more important. Like my trade is talking to people and working with the mind and working with emotions. That's my trade. And it's a long road to really lock into a trade like that. It's not like a mill or like a factory you can go for talking to people and motivating them and helping them be a better person and getting them out of a dark place and stopping them from, you know, committing the ultimate failure, and that's suicide. And it's like, it's a long road, but the Most High in the sky, I'm going to believe in the secret. The actual book, The Law of Attraction. And one of my things is I work for a job on the weekend with 6 mentally ill male patients in their late 50s, 60s, or whatever, but got minds of 10 and 9 and 15-year-olds and got schizophrenia and problems like that. And the Most High in the sky put me in that position to be able to do that. And it's like, it's teaching me experience, knowledge, giving me skills to take it to the next level for what I want to do the exact same thing, just for younger guys. Mm-hmm. And it's like my entrepreneurship. And that's what I try to preach to the young men. Like, okay, music is cool. I love music. Music saved my life. Hip-hop saved my life. music saved my life altogether. But on the same token, don't make that your main focus. If you got another gift or a talent or another trait that you can utilize to secure a bag, because that's the concrete brick foundation to your house.
Mm-hmm.
You can do it. Doing music should be your hobby money. That should be, you should have money put away that you can play with to be able to do music. It should not be your main focus to say, you know what? Hey, I ain't got a lot of money right now, but I'm going to put up $90 to go for the session right here to record all these songs right here because I know I'm lit right now.
I got a small example of this. Like, a bird dog going to just be going to be best at hunting birds.
Facts.
But he may not know he a bird dog from the beginning. He might not understand that he a bird dog from the beginning. He could have got left with a bunch of rabbit dogs. And when he figure out that he can hunt birds better, he going to do it better. You know, so what you need to do is seek what's within you. And when you seek what's within you and what's better in your nature to do, then you're going to be able to produce better fruits on whatever action you take. You're going to be able to produce better fruits on whatever action you take.
Right.
If you find out what your motor is best at. That's a track. You got tractors and then you got hot rods. A hot rod going to do this eighth in 4 seconds. The tractor ain't. But if that hot rod break down, the tractor can pull it all the way home. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, you got to find your gear. And whatever your gear is, whatever you feel the best at, that's what you're going to be the best at. You know what I'm saying? So we ain't get taught that science. Not in my lifetime. I'm 41. In my lifetime, I don't see that science being taught, like, to look for that gear and try to work that gear right there. You know what I'm saying? I get paid for talking. That's what I get paid for. Now, I cut hair. I do a lot of things. I sell things.
A lot of
hours. I promote things. I exalt things. I do a lot of things. I educate things. I bring things. I sing things. I can go on and on. But what I really get paid for is to talk. Even when I'm cutting hair, or even if I'm cutting hair, I'm really getting paid for my conversation.
You saved a lot of lives.
Talking, and that's my best gear.
You have saved a lot of lives.
So I go. But back to this. We're going to get into this, man. When I first met you, man, no, I ain't never first met you. I knew you ever since you knew you.
Facts.
So I ain't never, ever first meet you. Let me kick that out of my head.
Same
way. When I first challenged the fact of whether you wanted to do music for real, and Pooh was telling me, hey, Space got bars. Shout out to Daryl Pooh. Shout out to Daryl Pooh.
Papa P.
El
Tholo. That's my new artist right there. OG Drip. OG Drip.
He OG to us, man.
OG Drip, El Tholo. It's only three careers. North, South, and Daryl career.
When I first challenged you as a... when I first challenged you as an MC, I took you to the crib with me, right? And we went next door to my people house. And we got over there while we could play the music loud. And I bumped some beats. And I started freestyling on you. And I challenged you. And, man, you turned up like some kind of werewolf. He did, man. He was like, gee, you think I can't do this?
Yeah.
Watch this. And he started rapping. He never stopped. I said, man, I called everybody. I called everybody because I was like, yo, it's a killer loose. Man, I'm trying to tell y'all it's a killer loose.
That'll remix them.
Y'all ain't know this. And he freestyled so elegantly that I knew it was a killer loose. Now, what we want to get you now is what we going to do is we going to hear you or something.
Yeah, we
going to
hear something.
Is we gonna hear you or something? We in time.
Lord, I'm burning. Man, come on, man, join the party.
Nah, man.
Come on, man. Look, man, it's Friday. We ain't got no job. I'm gonna get you high today.
CBD.
Look, we ain't going
to one more thing. Watch, Savage, shout out to Newport. Shout out to Newport. We need that sponsorship.
Ty Bill, what up, baby? Let me see that right quick. It's Baca. About channeling, man. Man, like LeBron might be upset because people were mad at him because he went from LA from Cleveland or whatever. And but he go play the game or whatever, and he play against Cleveland or whatever, and he channeled that anger that he feel about his city talking about him like that because he trying to do better things for his family. And he go crazy and score 58, 60 points. And they like, man, LeBron had 60 points tonight in Cleveland. Well, why you think so? He felt a type of way. He had to take all that anger and all that backlash or whatever and all that negativity and channel it some kind of way. So he balled out against Cleveland, let y'all know, like, hey, how could y'all talk about me like that? I'm y'all child.
Who you going against?
It's like, man.
I got lost. You jumped in there, but I'm stuck right now.
You want a beat or you just want to do this acapella?
Yeah. I want the beats, man.
You want beats?
Yeah.
All right, let's get some beats. Let's get a beat going, man. Let's get this done, man.
We're going to pop it. I got Three Style Fridays, man.
Three Style Fridays.
That's not a freestyle. Three Style
Fridays on Terry Richmond Jr.'s page.
He ain't tapping on the
parentheses, the space though. The space is on there though.
All right.
That little baby.
Y'all getting ready to get with y'all.
That little baby dog.
Hey, look, we ain't even tell y'all. We missed to announce that space is like one of the best freestylers that we know and that anybody could ever know. You know what I'm saying? He don't fail at this.
Is that which gun?
Y'all gonna see something.
Yeah, what's that dude young? Man, ain't no one. Just pick one.
I don't see what he can do with this one right here.
What we got? Alright.
Wait, speak it then. Let's throw that shit off. Get up to it.
Yeah. Shout out to Tuba.
This is that motherfucker.
Try to tell you it's a killer. What the fuck you gonna kill him, boo? My nigga shoot pussy to kill us too. Brothers, what we gonna do? Y'all ain't running on only you. Color be creepin', y'all niggas be waiting and sleepin'. We be sick in your ass, 9 a.m. in the morning. While you still yawning, you be warming. Scaling the ball and shit, like the Capitol and shit. Y'all thought we dressed in black for nothing. Y'all thought we was slacking or something. Got my man Space in the back. She's getting it on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, you can get the handicap.
Hey yo, the time is Hey, yo, can I spell the dragon one time, man? You in the weed over there? Check my network, so you niggas thinking that I'm broke. Well, shit, even if I die, something told me I'ma still have some kind of wealth. Now I call that black wealth. And messing with the space, well, boy, that be bad for your health. Cause any 16 squad, put COVID-19. That's right, Corona. And I ain't talking about what you drinking on. So what you thinking, homes? You thinking that I'm washed up? Ain't no way, boy, ain't no plate in the motherfucking sink, homes. I got my link homes, and I'm highly connected. And the wild guy, you don't connect it like Wi-Fi, so try God. I call magic, yeah, why lie? Laughing, you niggas just like, hi, you rapping, yeah, you rapping with your capping, yeah, blah, blah, on gone. Smoking that season more, yeah, that lie, damn. I just want to sun all you niggas, so what you call me? I'm supreme, so you call me Dada. Now you feel me with laughter. And now you niggas is biting my style. What is you, Toronto? You a raptor? My baby mama name Paige. And now I'm on a whole different chapter. I'm getting ghost fight capital. And I'm in the spot to draft them. And you slave ass niggas need to know that I'm really just working on my master. Different degrees, I put them all on the wall. And matter of fact, you can put it in your grill, Paul Wall. And I'ma keep leaning on you niggas, dawg. Cause I think all niggas is funny. And you niggas thinking you real, I'm thinking you ain't real. You niggas is the Easter Bunny. See, I'm seasoned for every reason. And now you see, you niggas wanna be beefing. And I'm smoking this green, dawg. I'm chilling, dawg, I'm trying to be beefing. Now I'm trying to smoke on the leaf. And on the chronic leaf. And trying to get some kind of relief. But you niggas wanna stress me. See, I ain't the EOG. Or the SAT, so why the fuck you wanna test me? And now, dawg, listen to this, it's the spaceship. And I ain't the doctor, but y'all wanna test my patience. And this shit's crazy, dawg, you better surf it. Cause what this is, that's that radical wave shit. And see, they say I'm the one. So actually, what they meaning, dawg? Well, they saying I'm in the matrix. And y'all say shit, and y'all mean it. And yeah, I ain't flossing, but this shit is bossing. That mean the shit I'm smoking known as the greenest. And you niggas saying I'm washed up, but stop it, dawg. Cause ain't no way that niggas' face is in the cleanest. And yo, I just took a chick right off your penis and gave a penis. Give me something, man. Yo, Yatel, Big Threes, man. Yatel West, man. Radical way, man. Hey, yo, two with the juice, space with the sauce on the way, man.
Shout out to Vodka. All white. All white.
Yo, tune in,
water
and
DJ. Shout out to Vodka.
Water, shout out to Water. DJM.
Shout out to Water. All the companies. Water. Gentlemen. We need that sponsorship. I'm trying to tell you.
Let it dress.
We want all the way to night. We want all the way. We got faith.
We need something.
I mean, if you got the damn, you know what I'm saying?
Talk out of money.
Yeah, I feel you.
So, that means Spacey trying to make chubby. Meaning, you voice might be talking to the north, like Florida, I'm trying to enjoy the main weather. I mean, life real good, bitch. My nigga Tyler Bill came to me and said something to me. Say your space. You gonna stop playing with these niggas, hey, and just get cake, and just be hood rich. Over my nigga named Chief. And every nigga named Space, but some people named call me Butter. Too smooth to stutter. So what you saying, when it's my turn, I'ma roll up the gas, let the blunt burn. See, I'm smoking on that Usher. So what this shit I'm blowing on is that nitro. So this is that flame in the game, pyro. Oh, you know what it is, I'm soaking up the way. So I might be smoking nitro. I'm smoking on her. Well, I'm smoking on the water. See, everything is good to you. See, I came through and changed the game. Now it's stormy. See, this is how I look and change the weather. And the weather never changed. See, I came from that game town jumping, so what I'm saying, I'm on that ape shit. Everything's a orangutan. See, I'm around crazy niggas. You, where, I don't know what to think. You don't know what to do. See, some brain real, some bang blue. Oh, and the crazy part about it, well, they got a heater that'll bang you, and fuck that shit, they'll bang your boo. Damn, now you over there looking baby blue. Damn, that shit is crazy, dawg. Now your shit is looking sick. And what about me, that nigga Space? Well, number one draft pick. I am so super, but fuck all of you losers. Cause I know this shit is a hood classic. See, I'ma make this shit stretch like plastic. See, what I'm saying, niggas really average. And I'm trying to really think about this for battle. Cause they say it's a gift, and the boy driven like a phantom. So they say I am so super, well, that's my anthem. I just popped out of this shit. She called me handsome.
What do you think about your anthem?
What should I hop about a band, man? And they telling me I can do whatever I want to do. So what I say, hell yeah, but I can, man. So what I'm saying, I'm feeling like Adrian Berlin, nigga. I'm the can, man. With the man that he can. And that shit is crazy, cause that nigga see me more. It made me crazy with a can in his hand. Just spraying like he's spraying his drugs. What the fuck? And I'm like, my nigga, chill. He like, hell no, we gotta turn this shit up in the wild bill. See, I'm rolling, dawg.
Stay dangerous.
And I'ma stay open. And I don't even need pills, but even I'm on the Adderall. Well, I'm the baddest, dawg. And this is the crazy thing about it, dawg. You understand, you rap like this. But shit. It's like fingers when I'm snapping, dawg. Now, I'm in the auditorium and everybody around here clapping, dawg. And y'all niggas say you're in the gymnasium. I think you lying, but go ahead, have a ball. You said you had the microphone in your hand. Well, that was the master plan, but go ahead, pass it, dawg. Nobody wanna hear that shit. Look at his face, them niggas been crazy. But yeah, that boy's been the realest shit. And go and get checked, that window, the clearest shit. Now you can look out the window, cause I just looked over. And now I see something looking out my window while I'm sleeping on this window. On this window that I'm sleeping, I'm living a different room. And then you can see I'm in a super space. So you can't see me, dog. You gon' need something with a telescope. And while my nigga selling dope, I'm selling hope. And while my nigga selling green, I'm selling dreams. So what the difference between you and me is the 16. The 16, well, I was spitting way before I was 16. So in the verses, I was working in the verses, saying that I'm washed up. You crazy out your mind, you better pull away the damn detergent. Nigga, I ain't no clothes, though. Go against me, I treat you like toes with open toes sandals, nigga. Exposed, though. You a bozo. You a clown, nigga. In the lobby, I get Bobby on that ground, nigga. In the new edition. And now my repetition. Send me people to go, that won't start a petition. So it's been in a whole bunch of names, boy. I'm too advanced. You don't want playing this game, boy. Shit ain't Nintendo. And see, the difference between you and me, I'm that flame, boy. I'm talking about that endo.
Yeah.
You have just arrived in space.
He
ain't telling big threes, man. I
have just arrived in space.
In case you've been living under a rock, you have no idea. One, it's absolutely delicious. It is so delicious. It's every single
shit, smoothest suede shit.
Oh, cut it on a custard beat.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Mm. Maybe mutants. I think I looked at, man. I watched X-Men and stuff, and it reminded me of us, really. I mean, I was wondering, was we mentors? What y'all think from the outside?
That's oh, point. Let me get that little baby and oh, friend. I'll do that right there. What?
That's for a friend. Mm-hmm. What we have here is a spaceman is about to pull a
rhyme. Yeah, for me. What else you got? J2!
He's about to pull a rhyme from the dirt. And if you have a problem with people hearing your voice, by you.
Wait, sorry for the food. Sorry for the space doing the way. Whoa. Yeah. I guess when these rhymes that I throw up, when I flow up, yeah, I regurgitate. Give you a reason to feel bad. Now you mad, dog. Yeah, you gotta learn to hate. They left me to a reverberate. I'm up there with the greats. And I came from the Yanktown jungle, and I'm going eight. Murder scene, somebody bring the yellow tape. See, and I'm in a different state. And you a featherweight. I'm in the heavyweight. Me is on a different weight class. This story unravel, scrabble eggs, make you break fast. Now you out of here, in the morning like Alonzo. Get long money, talking about like the nose on Gonzo. Get to it like Bronzo. Oh yeah, now you chiefin'? What about me? Well actually, I've been legally. Now that I got this microphone, let me give myself a whole interview. As a matter of fact, let me tell you exactly what you finished with. End up being a nigga that I killed, nickname it my interlude. As a matter of fact, I'ma get my money swung, your inner tooth. Now I'm saying, I can be riding like a bike, yo, with two wheels. The difference between me and you, y'all got different skills, got master skills. And y'all niggas can kiss my ass for real. Y'all need the song, most of y'all need mass and gear. See, I just fast and kill. See, you just have a feel. And see, y'all niggas mad at me, well, go ahead and grill. Y'all mean muggin', that shit don't mean nothing. Y'all niggas think you bad, niggas ain't really thuggin'. See, I be the box stars. And when they get to clickin' with that thing and they get to singin', you be singin' like a hot one. And I roll with real niggas, real deep, shit like monsters. And y'all niggas think you beast on beat. But really, y'all niggas sweet, nigga Pop-Tarts. Put you in the microwave. What about space? I'm that way. You on microwave. And me, I drop rhymes, sit on your mind. Microbraids, play this game, different way. Hell yeah, RK, spaceman, smoke you like the ground. Why stargaze? Matter of fact, wave life. What I do? Start waves. You don't know me? Where you been? Stuck to what? In the cave? What about me? Hit the stage, put them on. In the days, black girls, white girls. Go ahead, make a rave, space dog, who is he? Blaze it dog, the dude craze. Matter of fact, everybody wanna go ahead and catch that. Like a bus nigga, you trust nigga, you click nigga, you don't bust nigga. Matter of fact, my nigga shoot the thing in the rain. Let it rust nigga, fuck around, turn your ashes. Now your ass is dust nigga, what about me? Eat the beat, it's something about it. Got a lust nigga, it's a fetish, I can't help it. Matter of fact, a little skeptic. Matter of fact, let's get it out of here. Let's make this shit very clear. Man, I'm in a different time zone in a different year. To you, it was 2021. To me, it's 2120. See, I'm in a different place. That's space. That nigga used to be known as Buddy. Oh, man, let me get that little baby and our $42 we paid, man.
He said that nigga used to be known as Buddy. I got a different name in the hood. They call me Buddy.
How many viewers we got?
Cold and flu symptoms make working from home harder.
Can I see?
With BC, get relief at the speed of powder and balance work life and home life with ease. BC Powder, when you have to be your best right now.
What shit? They're going to tune in and see some shit they ain't seen. I know that.
Who is USAA made for? It's made for him, a veteran who honorably served. And it's made for her, who she's serving now. We also make USAA for military spouses and their kids. Become a member. Get an insurance quote today.
Dope boy be cooking.
Hold my phone, brother. Dope boy be cooking. I need to go ahead and work from the camera.
Yeah,
get low, all
They been cooking, tell the truth. They been cooking, y'all know they cooking. On the dope, get low, all the fiends they be looking. They be driving, they be looking. All the dope boys is cooking, they be cooking. They be cooking. Real shit, they be cooking. When the dope get low, all the fiends they be looking. They be cooking. And look, all the dope boys be cooking. They be cooking, they be cooking, they be cooking. They some chefs, they be cooking, nigga.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
Most definitely.
Damn.
Yeah.
Nigga talk about me. Little nigga, I bench stress. Let me get some things on my chest. Little nigga, like I'm bench pressing. I'm teaching this game. Used to be a student, now I'm giving lessons. We get paid, boy. Step out, everybody sharp. Number two, everybody on blade, boy. Better go ahead and surf that. Yeah, boy, that's the way, boy. Y'all niggas talking about y'all turf, y'all fade, boy. Artificial, we beneficial. Get money, beneficial. What about space? Been an issue. Y'all saw Ben tissue, charming. My goons, bees, dog, get swarming. What about you? Sunny day, all of a sudden, they storming. Lightning, thunder, Stevie, wonder. Now, your best friend, someone down under. Damn, now, we walk away his grave bag. You ain't gotta ask the questions. Right here with a wave at. Out of here, baby. It's crazy, that's what they said. All on they mind, no rhyme. Yeah, I've been here a long time. Go ahead, think back. When I used to be TSI, call myself Lyrical God. Now nothing ain't real. Y'all niggas all frauds. What about me? What about me being here? All y'all saying I be that weirdo. Taught these niggas about swag. I saw God, I'm a hero. Man, you pick another beat, man. Oh, man.
When the dog get low, all the fiends, they be looking, they be looking.
Well, what's some man back in the day, man?
We developed soldiers like yourself.
The dog boy be cooking.
We passed the beat right now, man. I did that already. I thought you got a big mask off.
I thought we was gonna clown everybody. Live and direct, try to be first and foremost. So we push it, try to be a TV. As we push it, try to be a TV. We're trying to let y'all
try
see.
Be a TV yeah. The way.
We're trying to let y'all see what's going on in the craters. And in the craters is where mixes get made, chemistry gets mixed. It's dangerous to happen in a place like Charterville, a place where only real niggas act. TV, man, it's a place where only the real at.
Give me your beat, boy.
Well,
so I can go lay some of this heat, boy.
Capture these real
some of the more mindset keys, boy.
Okay.
I started to get on my
own. We're going back to space.
I don't know if you got the giant game, boy. I don't want to carry your beat, boy. I'm talking about KB's, I'm talking about Mr. Rocket Team of Grady. What about space? Stay lazy. What about my life? Well, I was saying with some different beat, man. Please. I just went on a different beat, everybody. Top of the TV. Way. Space is the way. Top of the TV is the way. Coach is the way. Bob is the way. Yamamay is the way. Shout out. Shout out to my brother Shawshank the Ghost Producer, man.
Who is Shawshank the Ghost Producer?
Man, that's Big Bro, man.
Oh, I know him. Dwayne.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Shawshank, Shaw.
Ghost Producer. Much love, respect. OG, triple, quadruple.
Gotta work.
Centennial OG. He got a whole army of people out here that he helped make a product of.
So Harper is an out and the parents don't know we're together. So her parents are believing that their straight daughter brought home the lesbian.
Give me something that everybody know. That mask off is crazy. I know.
Ooh. You ready for this one? You ready for this one, Sebastian?
Oh, it's hot.
Yeah, we're going out. We're finna go back to space. To space. What is this space? The space is that black way in that backdrop in my shirt right now. And I say it's my hat. It's the space.
So this is I could take my mask off. Wait a minute, if there's money on my mind, then it's going 30. I gotta get that cash, dog. We are fast, dog. Quick. Handle my business, that's the reason for this certain time. They call me space. Well, if you looking for it, then most likely you gon' probably see me in the sky. Out of here, baby. And I'm extra weight. Boat, nigga. In the location. Can't even find us remote, nigga. And I put it on soft shake. Yeah, ghost, nigga. That's toast, nigga. Get that brain. Big cat. I'm at their head with all they capping and what they rapping. Y'all, dog. That ain't what's happening. My fingers, dog. When I get to snapping, we in the kitchen, most definitely back to trapping. Gotta whip it up. Gotta get it, bro. Talking about get your paper, make sure them chips is up. Stack them like crazy, that's the reason for all of these things. And making sure I get this Krispy Kreme, man. Yeah, like Santa Claus. What about me, nigga? Man, I'll be off the wall. Like Mike Jack. Told you I'll be right back. Oh, yeah, man, I'ma get it if I like that. Yeah, and like three ninjas gotta strike back. Oh, I gotta make sure I got these tight wraps. Nah. I can't lose the gang out in the palm of my hand. So I make sure that I squeeze it, boy. They say it's hard work. But it say space. You make it look easy, boy. I do that ball work. What about me? Well, you can fuck around and have to see a starburst. Thinking everything sweet like candy, nigga. I be rolling with the business, keeping some handy, nigga. They got the palm of hammers and not deodorant. But I'm talking about be keeping on deodorant. It can get real stanky, just like that leg, nigga. Yeah, matter of fact, they be married to their people. Nah, but dog, they ain't new to grids. Yeah, I be at their head while I'm on their mind. And I'm in their brain. Yo, it's EA. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. That's basically what that mean. That mean I'm in the game. I'm crazy out my mind. So when I run, my only thing is boy spit insane. I be looking at my brain like I'm looking at my mind. Man, you on space time. And I ain't running out of time. You talking about your time. Well, all my clocks and watches, they be set to space time. And they call me Space Griffin. Cause I slam dunk anytime I'm on the baseline. Watching on my iPhone, trying to get me some space time. Never on snip that, no joke like Coke, nigga, baseline. She said she wants some kids, so I let her swallow and taste mine.
We found a lot of items of clothing. Like, we'll find, like, swim trunks and jeans and tank top. And, like, where did they go without their clothes? Hey.